Hello friends, hope you are doing good, and I'm really appreciating the way you are along with me throughout this journey of instructional design and the ADDIE model. So this is the last video where I will speak little about, you know, the last piece, the analysis, design, develop, implementation and evaluation. So when it comes to evaluation, certain things which we need to take care. Number one, the happy sheet. So why I call it as a happy sheet, that is called the feedback form, because feedback form normally within the training room, in the training setup, people always say good about the trainer because there is it's an influence. So the influence of a trainer on the participant, so that they always say good about that. But the most important thing is, if it is possible, if you really want to see the evaluation of your training program, take the feedback from the participants in the workplace. When they go back to their respective places for the functional area, take this change in their behavior, should be spoken by other stakeholders like their line managers, their supervisors, those who are supervising them. So ask them, prepare a questionnaire, send them the sheet, and is there any change into their behavior? So first of all, if there is a change in the behavior, if you have impacted their behavior through your whatever intervention you have made during the training program, if they are at here, and if there is a change, and because of that change they have reached up to this level, so this is what, you know, the gap which you have completed, and which you have fulfilled this gap, and people are up to this level, maybe the expected level of the organization, of the people where the people need to perform. So when the people have enhanced into their, you know, behavior, is this behavior is really impacting on the field where they are working? That is called the learning transfer. So when it comes to learning transfer, the learning transfer is not transfer in the classroom. Learning transfer happens when they perform into their day-to-day job. So this is what which will help all of us, you know, when you send this questionnaire and the feedback form to their supervisor, and when they are really making change and impacting the interaction what they are doing with the customer, that's the real change happens, and this is what the change which will impact the business. So our ultimate criteria, that's okay, this is all bits and pieces, whatever we do, we are very good facilitator, we are very good in terms of conducting activity, we are very good in terms of conducting and organizing the training program. We are very good in terms of telling the stories to the people. We may be very good in terms of the overall orientation into the class and impact on the people. But the most important thing, the success of the training program lies when these people implement on the workplace, and whatever they implement, because of the change in their behavior, understanding and their level is up now. So when they implement it, they are really able to influence their customer, and they are really able to fetch the business for the organization. And is it really something which is helping you? So always, so there are few things are there. Do not always, you know, tell people that this has happened because of me. No, this is not because of only you. This is what the cumulative effort of the line managers, their supervisors, what they are putting. So guys, success is all yours. Failure is all mine. So well, let's people speak about good about your training program. When you send this feedback form, collect this feedback form. What I would request to all of you, that if you can send this Google Doc, you know, format to all the people and have this inventory, because when you send this through Google Doc, that will give you the complete, you know, computer presentation and the graphs where you can see the enhancement into the behavior of the people. So have some certain questionnaire on the behavior, have certain questionnaire on the knowledge level, have certain questionnaire on the overall skill level of the people. So when you send this all, you know, set of questions to the people, let their line manager should go through for the initial change into their behavior and impact on the business, and overall how long you will be going to be in touch with these people, maybe for 3 months or the 6 months, the follow-up is really important. So one important thing here, you conduct the training program, that's very good, but the success lies in the follow-up. Many of our colleagues, they are very good and very good in executing the training program, but they fail in terms of the right follow-up. So make sure that you follow people on the regular intervention. You can develop a, you know, weekly follow-up plan, even the bi-weekly follow-up plan, the fortnightly follow-up plan, monthly follow-up plan, and quarterly follow-up plan. And this follow-up plan should be of the actual format. Guys, when it comes to taking the feedback from the people, always send the format, because format is always the written document which is there in your kitty. So when it comes to showcasing the organization that this has happened and what is the impact on this training program, that is called the actual ROI which has impacted on the business. So my request to all of you, follow all these things in your day-to-day program. And when it comes to keeping the stakeholders informed, always keep your stakeholders informed whenever you are reviewing people, whenever you are doing the follow-up with the people, this is the impact. this is what the change in the business, this is what the change in their behavior, this is what the level change into their skill level, so that these people are now better in terms of having the more and more when the good discussion, meaningful and fruitful discussion with the customer, their knowledge level is up, their skill level is up, their whatever the, you know, customer one-to-one interaction is really higher up. So this is what which will help your organization and your important key business stakeholders to understand that this is what the training has made the impact. So overall it should be a win-win situation for the business, and believe you me, we are ultimately working for the business. We are the very much important support function for the business, and we are there for them. So hope this is useful to you. Follow this, you know, the entire EDI model, and my request to you, subscribe to the channel and please share this with your all the colleagues and the friends, so that we all will win at the end of the day. So friends, thank you so much for this journey along with me for this EDI model and for the instructional design. So when it comes to, there are many more parts, many more things are there which I did not discuss because of the paucity of the time and the resources. But definitely when it comes to the classroom training program, we can have this, you know, the larger and the bigger perspective for each and bits and pieces of the instructional design, where we can really actually put people on the, you know, on the job activity and the group activity, discussion, briefing, debriefing, and some game and the activities also. So thank you so much for being with me throughout this journey of instructional design. Hope this is useful to you. If this is useful to you, first of all, implement into your day-to-day job, into your training program, whatever you are doing, or your field training, or you have the classroom training, and share it with others. Thank you so much. I wish you all the best to be a successful trainer or a successful instructional designer now. Thank you.